Hey guys, welcome to Bandra Bucket. And today, as you know, I'm in Ajmer, and this is my second last destination of the entire theme travel of the Sufi trails of India. And at night, I have a train to Ratlam. Ratlam would be my last destination, and I would be visiting Hussain Tekri in Ratlam to commemorate the 40th day of Ashura. But before that, I'm enjoying a nice evening besides the Anna Sagar Lake in Ajmer. This is a man-made lake. It's quite deep though, but it's a very beautiful lake nestled between the Aravali mountain range. And as you can see, the evening time, the late afternoon time, this water, it seems like it's a sheet of gold, and I'm cruising over it on this motorboat over here. And the breeze is making ripples into the water, and it's a very mesmerizing feeling, very soothing destination, I would say. You should come over here to enjoy. If you are coming to Ajmer, this is a must to visit place, and especially in the evenings, late afternoon and evening time, it looks very beautiful and very pleasant, I would say. All these families are enjoying their vacation over here, and I'm just trying to capture this beautiful place for you and into my memory also, for my memories also. And this lake is, as I said, this is a man-made lake, and it's quite deep though, and the water is also very clean. Usually lakes are not very clean, but this lake is very clean. And in between this lake, there is an island, a small island, and there's a garden in it. You will see later on. These are all kids. They are going to have a very good time over here. As you can see, I'm totally sun tanned, and since 1 month I am out of my house. I am far away from my home, and I've been traveling. It's been almost 1 month, and few more days. One more day in Ratlam, and then I would be heading home. But I am going to miss all these memories, my friends which I had made in the hostel, and these very new places which I have experienced. And it was actually the deep curiosity in me to travel India right from top to bottom. Actually, though the South India is still to be explored, and inshallah, maybe next visit is going to be South India, starting from Karnataka to Andhra, Hyderabad, Bangalore, Kanyakumari, and enjoying this evening. As you can see, it's a very beautiful scenic view from this little island. Ajmer itself is also a very beautiful town. It's a town of Sufi saints, and a place where two cultures blend together, and you will find the colorfulness, the brightness of Rajasthan, and the mystic aura of the Sufis over here. Though I couldn't visit Pushkar, but maybe next time, when I am planning to do an exclusive theme travel on Rajasthan itself, wherein I'm going to visit other destinations of Rajasthan. I found Rajasthan very beautiful. It's a very colorful place. There's so much of variety over here, and even the landscape, the cultural diversity over here. There are so many tribes, and the wildlife. You will have lakes over here. You will find mountains. You will find good food, good cuisine, and it is one of the biggest manufacturers, biggest producers of saffron, which is a very very precious herb in India and all over the world, and it's exported from here. And the architecture is also very beautiful of Rajasthan, especially the public wells. I couldn't be to any of those, but in rural Rajasthan you will find those public wells. And especially I couldn't cover the important beautiful areas of Udaipur, Jodhpur, Bikaner, which is more towards western part. In Rajasthan I only covered Ajmer, Jaipur, and now in the evening I have a train to Ratlam, Madhya Pradesh, wherein I would be visiting Jaora, the Hussain Tekri, for the 40th day of Ashura. And as you can see, I would be missing Rajasthan. And Jaipur was also very good experience. I had planned to stay over there for just 3 days, but I ended up living over there for almost a week. And the hostel over there, especially Zostel, was very comfortable. It was very, very comfortable.